I've got selected in IAS in IA 2020 with rank of 70, 70, and this was my fourth attempt. Previously, I am working in IPS where I got selected in 2018, and before that I was in Indian Post and Telecom Accounts and Finance Services where I got selected in 2017. So this is the third service that I will join from UPSC. I will talk about overall strategy that I followed, and anyone can take any clue from this regarding prelims and mains preparation. So for prelims is, first of all, it's an exam of elimination. Here one needs to just clear the cutoff. There is no extra points, any bonus for getting a good marks in prelims. One needs to just clear the cutoff, but to prepare well for mains exam, because prelims result does not come just after the prelims exam. It takes at least a month for the result to come. So just to be sure that one is clearing prelims with a comfortable range of cutoff, one need to score at least 5 to 10 marks above the cutoff, so that preparation for mains can go on without any tension. Prelims has become nowadays quite unpredictable and a bit random also, because there are just 100 questions and lakhs of people are tested on those 100 questions only. So I'm talking about GS part of prelims. The other part, that is CSAT, that is aptitude part, that is that consists of maths and English part, and I did not prepare that for much because I was already an MBA graduate and an engineer, so I did not focus on CSAT part. The first part, that is general studies part, was my major concern. So for prelims preparation, I divided the total study into three different areas. One is static, second is current affairs, and the third is mock test and previous year papers. So one need to be thorough with static and current affairs before attempting any mock paper. So static is the base, it's the foundation. Static book list one can find from any popular website like Vision, Insights, IS Baba, any website. They give all the list of books what one need to follow for history, geography, polity, environment, economy, anything. So I followed, I took up one of such list and saw what all books they are recommending for history, for geography, and I purchased those books. Along with that, I also followed NCERT, especially for geography, history and economics. Especially NCERT of class 11th and 12th. So these basic static book I kept on revising again and again. And because I was studying from my home itself without any coaching, without any idea of how these subjects are, because I am a science student, always not into art subject, I found little bit difficulty in starting up the preparation. So I took the help of YouTube. YouTube has lot of channels with lot of videos explaining about, say, if you are not understanding what they're talking about in art and culture, there are many websites like Mrunal is there, and such other websites are there where you can find a series of videos explaining, where a lecturer is explaining everything. So that becomes very comfortable for an aspirant who is preparing for home. And similarly for geography, I followed some YouTube channel series. For history also I followed. So somehow my 50% of preparation came from YouTube and websites only, and they acted like coaching institutes for me, and it was very comfortable preparing like that. So static part, one need to be very thorough. For that, one need to study once with full understanding and then keep on revising on that. Then current affairs, again, because I had just 3 to 4 months of time for appearing for prelims exam, I could not start reading newspaper because it would take 1-1.5 hours minimum for someone who is starting up with newspapers. So again, I searched on YouTube and I found there are many channels which come up with daily news analysis kind of thing. So I just keep, I used to do lot of different works. Like I used to eat and keep on listening to those daily news channels and all, so that I save my time and also I keep on understanding what's going on. So this way I completed last 1 year syllabus of newspaper. I read 1 year newspaper like that on YouTube itself. I never read a physical paper because for me, I was really time constrained and it was going to take a lot of time. So once these things were complete, I went for appearing for test papers. So I took one test paper, like one institute's test paper as base material, and I prepared, I appeared for all the test papers like an exam, in an exam mode. So that one needs to know if one is guessing, how much of your guess is correct, how is your accuracy, and how much time you are generally taking for a two hour long paper, how much time you are yourself taking. So that's how I completed around 30 papers in exam mode, and along with that I completed some more papers, some full length paper for any kind of coaching institute I used to find on internet, so that I'm more familiar with question papers, questions and attempting questions and answers. There I never give, I just give these 30 papers in exam mode. Others I used to just attempt 10 questions and then see how those in 10 questions, how I fared and all. But I would say that test papers are the most important part of prelims preparation, because that's what give you a feel of real exam. How much ever you study and how much knowledge you gather, it won't matter if you are not able to produce it in the exam hall. So test papers give you the practice for that. So in all, I in exam mode and in non-exam mode, I completed around 50 papers. So I was very confident before going for prelims. So I would advise all the aspirants that go for test papers, and because preparation wise, current affairs and static preparation, you will never feel 100% confident that you know everything. Once you feel reasonably confident, just start appearing for mock test, because then you will be tested actually. This is for prelims exam. For mains exam, it's like 3/4 of prelims subject is actually 3/4 of mains syllabus is actually prelims syllabus itself. And for that, approach just needs to differ. For example, if one reads about any scheme in terms of prelims, one would read about its facts and figures and what are its provisions. But for the mains exam, the same scheme would be read about why and how. It becomes more analytical. Why the scheme was launched, what were the committee recommendations, were they followed, what are the flaws that experts are talking about in the scheme, what can be the better way to implement such schemes. And also, in mains preparation, the attitude towards writing exam changes. It changes from making it more factual to making it more analytical. That's what is actually general studies preparation is all about. The static portion that one reads for prelims is the base material for mains also. Plus there are few little bit extra materials, like for world history, one need to study in mains. And also for not just world history, there are some committee recommendations, like ARC recommendations and some committee recommendations which come up for any committee recommendation for any schemes that comes up, that keeps on appearing in newspaper, one needs to study, which we do not study for prelims, because that's only important from mains and interview point of view. So this approach is required in mains, and along with that, one needs to be very careful with optional selection and preparing for optional, because it's the optional only that in most of the cases takes you to a better rank and even for qualifying. So these are all general studies preparation, but one need not forget about optional. One more thing about general studies is that ethics paper is a different kind of subject. You cannot find anything directly related to ethics and morality in news or current affairs, but you need to infer. Ethics paper requires lot of examples which you can quote, and understanding of basic definition only. Because there is no standard source for ethics, you need not fear. Take it as a general studies paper, but give it an ethical point of view. Test everything what is there from an ethical point of view. What is right, what is wrong. One can prepare ethics from after taking clue from test series paper answers, model answers, how they are appearing, how they are writing the answer, how they are writing the case studies, how they are solving, what are the ethical terms they use in the answer. That one need to be careful about. Apart from that, no extra preparation for ethics is needed, that is GS4. And similarly for essay paper, essay is also one of such paper which is quite unpredictable, it is said. It's like either sometimes one get very high mark, which one does not expect, and sometimes also similarly very low marks. But one can assure that one gets an average mark with a decent preparation. If you read the essay guidelines in the Gazette, UPSC Gazette, it comes out that it wants us to write concisely, write in a flow, write in simple language. Only these 3-4 things, if one keeps in mind and keep the answer very diversified, keep one's essay very diversified, analyzed from different points of view, which one can do with GS preparation itself. Like GS 1 talks about history and geography, GS 2 talks about polity and international relations, then economics, then ethics. In all these angles, any topic can be analyzed in essay. So one, these 3-4 points, if one keeps in mind and keeps on writing essays, need not join one, need not be like you go to test series center and write and get it evaluated. You can write it yourself and just look at your own essay after 3-4 days. You will have a different set of mind while reading your own essay. I used to do like that and it helped me. So it's like essay preparation, one can assure that one gets an average mark. One cannot go below average if one is in writing in simple words, in lucid language, in a flow and diversified, and justifying the topic. It's not necessary that one need to cover up it with all the quotes and facts and figures. But yeah, this thing helps. But even if it is not there, it does not mean that one's essay becomes something which won't fetch you mark. It's not like that. So this is all about mains preparation. Thank you everyone, and I hope that you could take at least a bit of clue from this preparation strategy, and all the best for your preparation. Thank you.